Hello all. In this video, we are going to see a kind of poetry called ballad which exists in English literature. Literature is considered to be a writing that expresses one's thought, feelings, emotions, and attitude towards life. It is actually considered to be a communication through which the readers come and deal with the emotions that is happening around them. In English literature, we can find folk songs and comic verses are considered to be the precursors of ballad. In this video, we are going to see how old ballads got originated and how we can trace their existence. There is a proper definition given for ballad in English literature. It is considered to be a simple spirited poem written in short stanzas, and it actually narrates some popular story. There is a great influence which happened on later poetry, and it is because of ballads. Because ballads were composed between 1350 and 1550. So they have created a great impact in the field of English literature, especially in the genre poetry. In poetry itself, we have different kinds of poetry. Like we have ballads, epics, sonnets, reflective poetry, lyrical poetry. But in this video, we are going to trace the origin of ballad. The ballads are completely different from today's modern English because all the ballads were written in Old English. And it is said that best ballads have come from Northern England and Southern Scotland. And they were composed only in local dialects, the languages which are pertaining to regions. So there are many examples for ballads. To be put it in a nutshell, ballad is considered to be a narrative poem. It actually tells the story. The most important themes or the actions dealt in ballads were old favorites and violence. You can even find shocking and distressing scenes in ballads. For example, how children are thrown from castle walls, men butchered in family quarrels, how girls were seduced and cruelly murdered. These are the common subjects which one can find after reading the ballad. There is a popular example for ballad which is Hugh of Lincoln. You can also find the concept of nastiness which is predominant in old ballads. Old ballads actually started to have Scottish border stories. It talks about the violence of guerrilla war, which happens to be narrating the incidents of everyday life. One such ballad is Edom o' Gordon, which is a terrible story. It talks about Gordon's attack on the castle of the Rhodes. The another important subject in ballad is supernatural elements. Supernatural elements, as we know, it can be all about ghosts, spirits, evil things, and so on. So you can even find those features which are even relevant today. So ballad can also considered to be universal. So what are the elements predominantly existing in ballad, and their subject are ghost, magic, witchcraft, and superstition. There is always a superstition that both men and women, they are always afraid of war, and you can even see violence throughout the ballad. And there is also an expectation of supernatural existence in ballad. Lenore is actually a German romantic work written by Berger, which also talks about all these elements in a composed way. And Lenore has been written based on old primitive ballads. In the story of Lenore, you can even find a dead lover who comes to claim his bride even after his death. There are many examples which you can even find in Anglo-Scottish ballads, Clerk Saunders and the Demon Lover. One of the most hilarious and the predominant ballad is Wife of Usher's Will. There you can see three dead sons, they actually come to meet their mother at night and return to their place at dawn. It actually happens and it has its relevance in today's movies also. So these are things which are considered to be supernatural elements in ballads. And even we have this most famous character called Robin Hood. And in Balad, we have a separate section called Robin Hood Ballads, which you can find in films and television series. King Arthur is very famous in history, who also emerges as the most important hero in Balad. Robin, actually considered to be the greatest English heroes ever read and written in English literature. He is a real historical character who lived in the English North Midlands around 12th century. And there are many stories which are pertaining to Robin Hood ballads. You can even find the qualities of weakness, brave, generosity, humorous, how one defends truth amidst chaos. And those ballads are very less tragic and they are more humorous. And they are written pertaining to the taste of the young audience. Though it is not of high poetic quality, it is actually of some use of humorous sense to the readers. Ballads were considered to be the pop culture of those times. And there are many other examples for ballads. For example, Sir Patrick Spence, which actually gives you a tragic conclusion. It is not to be stated that ballads have to be in a humorous way. It can be in the other way around. You can even find Oscar Wilde, who has written brilliant comedies. He has also written tragic and magnificent ballads. Ballad of Reading Girl, which was written in 1896. Rudyard Kipling has also written many ballads, which actually considered to be the old form of ballads. So, in this part, we have seen what is ballad, what it is definition, what are the common subjects and examples. Thank you.